Hello, everybody. It is Shotaku Nirko, and I am back from my vacation. And that's a good and a bad thing for me, because now I'm bored. Now I'm very, very bored. Back in my room, back in my location, and there is nothing to do here. Gosh. Damn. But, yeah. So, with that, it's the... Hey, you stop that. Kurono Kuroku. But now it's time to go back to recordings. Anyway, let's get back into it. I do believe we were about here. Yes, let's do that. So, by the way, I completely forgot everything that's been going on, so I guess I'll have to relearn the storyline. Anyway, we got off at the junction and head toward the shopping district. Yeah, but who's you? Who's... Every time I like group?
ところで, 先輩とみーちゃんって結局何がどうなってたの?
After all, what the hell's going on? I need to go back and watch my own videos. I'm not gonna do that, but it'd be helpful. Misaki suddenly asked me that. Didn't you hear most of it from you?
だいたいならね。ただ それはみーちゃんの話で、先輩がどう思ってるかとか、先輩から見た結果がどうとかはわからないじゃない?それって不公平でしょ?
Oh, I can tell you how I felt about it. If we're talking about what I think we're talking about, and I think we are, I can tell you how I thought about it. It sucked. My boy here, Mr. Protagonist-kun, fucked up. That's what happened. So, I'm just putting that out there, just saying. Because he totally should have gone for that. 100%. No reason to back down. But, personal opinion, I suppose. Eh. Wow. That was unexpected. Not to mention impressive. Misaki wasn't observing the situation only from her best friend's side. Could that be something acquired from her upbringing? Or just part of her personality? It seems like it'd probably be the latter. Well, the way I see it, I don't think there's much different in how things turned out from what Miyu would have told you. Miyu is definitely not someone who would tell lies or hide things up from others' safe face. But I'm guessing Miyu didn't tell you about how I got a broken heart from it all.
失恋?
Yes, right in two, just snap completely. Ugh. We spent so much time together that I couldn't help but fall for her. I ended up being turned down. Were you though? Were you really? Cause from what I recall, totally could have gone for it. Turned down my ass.
みーちゃんのこと、今でも好きなの?
Yes. Yeah, but I wouldn't say I liked her in a sexual way. I guess you could say my lingering affections for her are a different kind of like. Yeah, I'm with you, Sumire. The hell is he talking about? You took that better than I thought. I figured you'd freak out on me or something. Well, stop being a fucking Sumire all the time. Misaki glared at me for a moment, then her facial expression softened. Oh, now you're calling out my family! Alright, fine. Well, yeah, you know, you got a pretty disrespectful opinion of me yourself.
お互い様!
Yeah, if you say so. As we agreed to disagree, I felt a deep sense of internal relief that she didn't interpret that discussion the wrong way. Since we were standing around in the middle of the street, it's an easy to spot. Soon enough...
あれ? レイ君とミサキちゃん?
Makoto?
二人で何してるの? こんなところで?
Well, clearly we're on a date, and I'm totally 100% going on a date before our date, because, you know, I'm good like that.
あれ? どこかでお会いしましたか?
I mean, you guys go to school together. Misaki gave Makoto an What the hell is that word? Askance gaze? I'm sorry I'm illiterate, everybody. But some words in here I've just never seen before in my entire life. Did she forget about her?
この前、こっちの悪い人から、ミサキちゃんに助けてもらった、人質役の城之内誠だよ。
Hey, my bad dude! What do you mean me?
悪い人でしょ?
I mean, well, I'd be lying if I said having a girl call me a bad dude doesn't get me a little excited.
あ、あの公園で先輩に絡まれてた。
Looks like Masaki remembered it after all.
Makoto-san と先輩って本当に知り合いなのね。
We're classmates.
そうなんだ。じゃあ、Makoto 先輩ですね。よろしくね、Misaki ちゃん。
Makoto's face lit up with a friendly smile.
それより、そっちは二人だけ?なんか妙な組み合わせだね。
Kinda just happened.
へー、初めて見たときは、レイ君もミサキちゃんも敬遠の中みたいだったのに。
Oh, that's because she was crazy. Our friendship formed out of a showdown at the beach on twilight evening.
日活ロマンだね。
アホだが。
Their opinions completely contrasted with each other. So are we going shopping or something, Makoto?
え?別に買い物とかじゃないんだけど、ちょっと。
Really? What's with the flustered look?
いや、ちょっと下見に。
女子会の下見か何かですか?
Misaki cocked her head in curiosity. So she's location scouting for a date, huh?Given how embarrassing that sounds, you sure seem to have a lot of motivation for it.
Senpai.
Hey, don't give me that look. Misaki poked me hard in the side. Gosh, damn, you're so fucking similar.
Dere dere shinai. Kyo no shuyaku wa watashi.
That was suggestive. Understood, your majesty.
Nanka, ojama datta kana.
When she saw Misaki and me, Makoto giggled and tried to excuse herself.
いいえ、Makoto 先輩も一緒に遊びます?
いいの?
はい。今日は何でもレイ先輩のおごりなんですよ。
Misaki started walking cheerfully. Makoto and I, the two upperclassmen, found ourselves exchanging glances.
Misaki ちゃんはちゃんと普通の女の子してて、見本になるね。
Ordinary my ass!That girl's so fucking tsundere. Now, admittedly, it's a good ratio of tsun to dere, but regardless, normal is not the word I would use. For the record, I never said that I was paying for anything. Makoto put her finger to her lip and thought for a moment.
私、男の人に気風のいいところを見せられると、ついついキスしちゃう癖があるかもしれないんだよね。
You cheeky little... But hell, I'm not complaining.
で?どうするの?
You'll get no more than 300 yen out of me for snacks.
やったね!
Makoto laughed and chased after Misaki. I took my time following them. I took my time following after them with a big fat grin plaster on my face. Jesus Christ! I know it's been a while since I've recorded, but holy shit. And I know Dondre's editing style, he's totally gonna leave that in. Fuck. Oh well. Nothing I can do. Moving on.Makoto seemed pretty jovial too. And so I became the loyal knight escorting these two princesses.
Rei-kun が失恋したってのは聞いてたけど、冗談じゃなかったんだ。
Why are we still talking about this?
無様ですよね。
Why you gotta put the salt in the wound? The two girls gleefully chatted away while glancing through their open window in the shopping district. As the lone guy in the group, I couldn't help but feel like a third wheel of sorts. Given the circumstances, I guess that makes me Larry. I'm sorry, what? No, wait. Larry actually had a role to play. This situation is making me feel more like a fake shimp. Why exactly are you guys talking about just me?
逆でしょ?楽しい話題を提供できるだなんて誇らしいことじゃない。はは
は。 I get this every damn day lately. And here, I was thinking people in the world took privacy seriously nowadays.
私と誠先輩の共通の知り合いが先輩だけだから自然と話題にしちゃってるんだけど。
Oh, I'm glad I'm such an interesting topic of conversation.
もし気にしてて傷つけちゃってたら
謝るわ。 Oh, you're talking about my broken heart? Not a big deal. I appreciate the sentiment. Nah, I don't have anything to hide. Not really embarrassed either.
いいね。それも人気。男の意地だ。
Makoto nodded vigorously, as if she was strangely moved by my previous statement. Given her family ties, I doubt her definition of chivalry is upstanding in the slightest. But never mind that. Well, that actually reminds me of something I wanted to ask. So putting me aside for a minute, have either of you ever had a boyfriend before?
The true question!
You brought it up first, didn't you? They couldn't get mad if I asked right now, so it's a good chance to find out.
私は彼氏がいたことなんてないよ。
Makoto answered honestly, without even breaking a sweat.
私は彼氏くらいいたことあるわよ。
Lies. Lies. Really now?
Oh.
Oh my indeed.Me and my fellow classmate had a want for further teasing. So how many boyfriends have you had?
え、何人?
まさか、美咲ちゃんほどのいい女なら、一人ってことはないでしょ?
Oh, we're about to grill the fuck out of you.
そうね、三、いや、五人くらいかしら?
It's so painfully obvious that she's lying, good gracious.I wouldn't expect nothing less from the Andal's prestigious daughter,
Andos.
So when did you go out with your first boyfriend? Last year, you've had four boyfriends on top of that since last year. That's like a boyfriend every 3 months. You are just batting and swinging, aren't you?
すごいな1年で5人も彼氏がいたんだ。
え、そんなに?あ、いや、ちょっと間違えたかも。去年じゃなくて3年前とか?
Really? 3 whole years ago? What precociousness?
本当、同じ女子としてリスペクトしちゃうな。
私からかわれてる。
Oh, we be having a giggle.
さ、レイ君、次は何して遊ぼうか。
To show Madam Misaki here an even better time, naturally.
うん、私も微力ながら協力するからね。
あなたたち、何をいい話としてまとめようとしてるの。
Not if I can help it. Misaki sounded like she were about to run me through.I couldn't help but get chills at her blistering, yeah, repose. Exquisite. Misaki, even your streaks of anger are simply exquisite.
だから、いい話とか深い話みたいにしてごまかすのをやめろって言ってるのよ。
Wait, were we insinuating something?
どこが?
さすがにもう、騙されないと思うよ。
I guess so. Misaki just isn't ready for prime time, I guess.
あなたは私を何だと思ってるの?
To tears formed in the corner of Masaki's eyes, and she stamped on the ground like usual. She's just too damn cute for words. Oh, that's right.
どうしたの?
There was a question I wanted to ask you two.
その前に私に言うことがあるわよね!
Oh, I don't need to thank you for entertaining us.
謝罪を要求してるのよ!
I already knew that. I just felt like egging her on one last time. If you had just one chance to turn back time and relive your life from any point in the past, how far back would you two turn the hands of time?
Huh?
時間を巻き戻す?
Yes, as in go back in time. I guess it must have been too sudden in asking that, since they were just stared blankly at me in response. You don't have to think about it too much, just a little survey I've been doing.
あなたとの出会いをやり直したいわ!
So you want to make it more passionate, eh?
今のこの気持ちを抱いたまま過去に戻れたら きっと真っ赤な情熱が咲き乱れたはずね
Hey, 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 hey You are a tsundere, not a yandere, so dial it back
レイ君 さすがに自重しないと過去どころか未来で刺されるよ
And you calm down there, Miss Yakuza. I had a similar hunch myself. Seriously though, do you really not have anything you want to do over, Masaki? I think everyone has at least one big regret from their past. Masaki's expression suddenly turned serious, and she mumbled something under her breath.
今のまま過去に戻っても仕方ないのよ
I couldn't quite discern why the mood had suddenly become very sullen But all the same, I didn't feel like teasing her Makoto also glanced at me with an expression that clearly said Not the right time, buddy And then
ちなみに、私はやり直したいことなんて何もないからね
Nothing at all? Like, not even a little bit?
ないよ
Maybe Makoto was trying to lighten the mood a bit, but her answer seemed so apathetic that there wasn't really anything else I could say. I see. Thanks, you two.
これ、何の質問だったの?
性格診断?
Something like that, actually. That's probably the best way to describe it. Ever since I acquired the power to rewind time, I've taken an interest in how other people think about the past and the future. It seems that people who want to go back in time several years and redo a massive portion of their lives really are few and far between. And I certainly wasn't expecting Masaki to give such a depressing answer. So now they're definitely both going to remember I asked them that. Sorry for asking you two. But I guess it would have been wiser to say that before I asked instead of after.
Eh?
だからさっきから...
Before Masaki could finish her sentence, I hurled my pocket watch against the ground. You couldn't just let that one go?
あなたたち、何をいい話としてまとめようとしてるの?
Whoa. Masaki's sudden close proximity to me made me jump with surprise. This is part where we were taking the... I'm sorry, what? The Mickey? The Mickey. We were taking the Mickey out of Masaki. Okay, well, I guess I'm just gonna hop on down to Disney and just get Masaki and just take Mickey Mouse right out of her wherever. Why? The Mickey? Why the Mickey? Such an odd phrasing. Maybe I got a little carried away. I'm sorry. Yeah, I mean, after we just took the Mickey out of here. The fuck does that even mean? My immediate apology quenched Masaki's anger instantly, leaving her gazing at me in confusion.
レイ君にしては切り替えが早かったね。
I just don't want to get shivved by her in the future, is all. I quietly explained myself to when Makoto pointed out my change of behavior. How about I treat you to some tea and cake to make it up to you?
謝罪があれば賠償はいらないわ。ケーキは先輩の私への好意としておごってもらうのよ。
大岡裁きだね。
Oka Takasake, Jesus. Eh? Didn't he once resolve a dispute between two women over the custody of a child by asking them to grab each of its arms and... Wait, let me explain any further.
Makoto-senpai, 何か美味しい店とか知ってますか?
Her anger having been extinguished, quite suddenly indeed. Asaka gleefully pressed Makoto for suggestions.
落ち着いて話せる場所で甘いものが美味しいって条件までつけると…当てはないかな
先輩は?
I don't usually go anywhere other than family restaurants and karaoke boxes myself.
噂通りお金持ちなのに、本当に普通の生活してるんですね。
You say it like it's a bad thing.
せっかくだし、お店の新規開拓をしようか。
その方が楽しそうですね。
Plus, if it goes bankrupt, I'll be the only one losing money.
また余計な一言。
Forget I said that. That's kind of a bad habit of mine.
そろそろ大企業の後取りだって教育を受け直した方がいいんじゃないの?
Flinging my snark right back at me, eh? I guess I know what I'm beat. Makoto, who had been looking around anxiously, suddenly made a weird noise.
あれは?
Oh my, that face! Dandre, make this the thumbnail! Just... Please.
何?
Misaki tried to ask her about it, but Makoto wobbled away on steady legs, without a response. Misaki and I glanced in her direction as she walked, and discovered Makoto was not being entranced by a cafe, but by a pet shop. It was a shop that had cages installed on the counters, and there was a corner where the customers were permitted to play freely with the animals.
Kawaii!
Kawaii desu!
Jesus. Misaki, are you an animal lover too? She immediately gave me an enthusiastic nod. Adorable rascal.
特に犬がいいわよね。きちんとしつけられている子が。主人に絶対服従で、命じられた通り機敏に動く子だったら、なおさら素敵。
Yeah, I figured you'd be into that. Her smile disappeared when I said that, just as expected.
先輩は猫派でしょ?
I mean, not exactly, but...
Yeah.
Serious talk, I do prefer dogs over cats. Just because dogs are more playful, but... I mean, cats are cool too. And my personality is a cat, so... I don't know. Am I a cat person? Oh. A question better answered by my editor, I suppose. That is a binary choice, which causes even deeper rifts between people that than their preferred type of cell phone. So I have to refrain from commenting. I pointed at the pet shop. So you want to go in there?
そうね。ちょっと私には子供っぽい催しな気もするけど、誠先輩も入ろうとしてるんだから仕方ないわね。
If Misaki had a tail, I'm certain it would have been wagging back and forth wildly in spite of this stony expression she wore on her face.
先輩は入らないの?
I'm good. And there's going to be cute girls playing with animals.I'd rather just watch.
先輩こそ、檻に入れた方がいい野獣なんじゃないの?
I'm not sure what you're talking about. A wolf then? I'm a wild and crazy guy after all.
羊の皮をかぶって草食の生活を送ってたら、居心地良くなって脱げなくなったふぬけみたいな気はするけど。
You're too sharp for me. And so...Makoto and Misaki, both seemingly in a trance, were given a brief explanation on the conduct from the store employee before they entered the cage.
Usa-chan!
Oh my gosh, I want the little bunny rabbit! And her face! Oh, this is... That's adorable. Why is there a dog butt directly in front of the screen, though? Evidently, Makoto had taken quite a liking to the bunnies.
Usa-chan, Tengoku!
Wearing an expression of absolute elation, she was hugging a baby bunny as all the other ones surrounded her, waiting for their own turn. She really did look like she'd died and gone to heaven. It was a wonderful thing to behold. Surely a gangster's daughter playing with a whole bunch of bunnies would make for a priceless photo. I took a stealth shot with my phone camera, and then turned my gaze to Misaki, Of course you wound up in that situation. In sharp contrast to the adorable voice ringing out before, her pitiful screams pierced the air. Mifaki! Obviously, no. Misaki fell on her backside as the dogs approached her from all sides. They surrounded her tactfully, approaching on their target. I thought she would have wanted to be jumped on a lot by cute puppies, though. Her awkward position had her visibly humiliated, but she couldn't bring herself to shoo the puppies off her. It's just what you think it is, fellow customers. That's my friend in there. Of course, one of the store employees recognized me as her companion and asked me if she needed any help, but I politely told them no. I'm such a nice guy. Makoto was in the same cage with her, so Misaki tried to send her an SOS.
Misa-chan!
Wow. Alas, Makoto is on a totally different planet right now. Who actually ends up in situations like this? Really? Now, don't get me wrong, I'm sure there's some people somewhere on this planet who 100% are accident prone enough to actually get like this, but how though? You know, they're like little 9-pound puppies. You can probably literally just move them. That lucky little... I couldn't tell exactly where those nasty dogs were looking at, but Misaki ended up letting out a stifled moan. Oh my gosh, good lord. That's hot. The sight made me want to get in and play with the animals too. I appreciate the fleeting glimpse of Misaki's panties that I got. The best part was that her tights clung to her legs and accentuated her curves. Sorry. There we go.
Nice.
This. Oh, look at the close-up at those thighs. Goodness. Bada bing! What's going on with your eyes right now? Misaki suddenly tried shouting commands at them. The puppy stopped for a moment at down boys, but then... Puppies wagged their tails and kept jumping all over her. They're puppy dogs. How hard is it to save yourself? Finally, Misaki started crying. Hold on, Misaki, I'll be there. I formulated a response in my head that sounded cool. Then I switched my camera app into video mode. Jesus Christ. I like to hear her make that sexy moan one more time. Jesus.
Usa-chan.
Oh, good lord, everybody's so hopeless. Watching the whole chaotic mess unfold, I stood there without a care in the world. How could I be forced to favor only one of these two charming young ladies? God truly has a cruel sense of humor. All the same, the day wrapped up on quite a high note for me. Well, that's some perfect timing, because that's kind of it for this recording anyway. So, we're going to leave that there. Wow, that's a pretty good welcome back episode. We had some snarky comments. The tsundere's back. Both good and a bad thing, I suppose. Snarky comments, tsundere's back, and Jesus. Quite the sexy scene for anybody with a decent imagination. But, yeah, so that was a good welcome back episode. I think this is a really good way to get back in the swing of things. But, I hope you guys enjoyed that episode. If you liked it, leave a like. If you really liked it, subscribe and check out the rest of the stuff on the channel. But that is it for now. I will see you guys in the next episode of Chrono Clock. But until then, Dondre, get me out of here. You little...